Hey everyone, welcome to today's only episode. We're going to explore the idea of only collecting watches from one brand, from Longines, this Swiss brand under the Swatch group. And I'm going to give you guys my picks. I'm going to choose three watches, one sport watch, one dress watch, and one wildcard piece that will hopefully bring a little bit of variety to the core collection, whether that is through material or size or color or complication, and really give you a good, strong base of three watches that can cover all of your needs as a watch enthusiast while still keeping your attention and your appreciation for this hobby of horology. Now let's get to it. My first watch is gonna be my daily wear piece, the watch that I wear most often, and that's the sport watch. I'm partial to divers. I like the water resistance. I like having an elapsed timer bezel. I do like having a date in my daily wear piece. So I'm gonna choose the Hydro Conquest in the special boutique edition, the green version here. I think this looks beautiful. As you guys can see, we have a polished ceramic bezel. We have a vertically brushed ceramic dial, I think is very attractive. And I like the fact that this is the smaller version, the 41 millimeter version. Most Hydro Conquests are 43, but I think the smaller proportions work better on a wider range of wrists, especially in a day-to-day situation, and especially with a design like this where the language has dominant lugs, dominant crown guards, and a rather large crown at the 3 o'clock position. Now let's turn the watch over, and you guys can see front and center in this case back is a beautiful medallion that has the winged hourglass logo that's done in a high amount of detail. I think it looks really attractive. And if you go just north and south of that, to the end links of the bracelet, you'll see a stainless steel tab here. This is the quick release. So you can take off this polished center link bracelet and snap in a fitted rubber strap done in the green color and also coming with a deployant metal buckle. I like the fact that you get two nice OEM options from the company, and that's gonna help bring a little bit of variety to this one watch. It's almost gonna feel like two different pieces depending on the day and depending on the strap that you put on it. Now this watch retails at $2,400. It's not likely you'll get a great discount considering it's a special boutique edition. The demand is gonna be higher than for the standard green that you can buy online that I don't think looks quite as good. But overall as a package, I think this would make a great daily wear watch, a great sports watch. Now what dress watch would I choose? When I wanna dress up, put on a suit, maybe take my wife to the theater. Luckily Longines has a ton of very sharp, very elegant dress watches. And if I'm only having one for the rest of my life, I want precious metal. I want gold. And it's nice that Longines does offer precious metal options. A lot of times they're gonna be small in diameter, like 35, 36 millimeters, but this one is 38 and a half. This is the Heritage flagship in 18 karat yellow gold. I think this looks absolutely beautiful. And it's reasonably priced for precious metal in this size and weight at $8,000 retail. The nice thing is it's still relatively available even for a limited edition of 60 units for the 60th anniversary. And this one you can still find in the low 6,000s. It has a beautiful sub-seconds layout just below those beveled Dauphine style hands. There is a nice applied yellow gold logo, winged hourglass logo, and Longines brand just below the 12 o'clock marker. And I like the mix of Arabics and these coffin style applied markers set on a domed or angled dial. I think the look is timeless. I love it in precious metal. I like the size too at 38 and a half. And I think this makes a great 1-2 punch with my green Hydro Conquest pick. Now, what would I choose as the last watch to really tie the trio together and bring a little bit of variety? I already have fairly different watches in the diver and the precious metal dress watch, and I think I'd like to add a complication, perhaps a chronograph. And looking at this, part of me says go wild, right? Go with the Heritage mono pusher chronograph with the alligator strap and the slightly angled dial configuration, but I think over time, again, we're picking for the rest of your life, I would get sick of the orange Arabics there. And I think I wouldn't wear this one as much as I should. And considering my first two picks, considering the dial colors of silver and brushed green ceramic, I think it would be wise to add a nice black dial, something that's a little bit more versatile, which might be contradictory considering this is more of a variety wild card pick, but I think black would bring some more strength. So I'm gonna choose the award-winning watch from the 2017 Grand Prix de Horology, the revival winner. This is the Avigation Big Eye. And I've actually owned this one myself. I have reviewed it on the channel. This one retails for $2,625, sells for a little under $2,000, and I think is awesome for an automatic chronograph with a Vaoju 77 base movement. Now, the thing that I kind of don't like about this one is the closed case back. It is done well, but you don't see the modified movement that they have in here that has a beautiful blued column wheel chronograph. I think that looks excellent. As you guys can see from this picture, when I took it to my watchmaker and we opened up the back and we looked at this tastefully finished automatic chronograph, it has nice actuation when it comes to the function pushers. And I like the asymmetrical layout of the dial, the big eye over at the 3 o'clock position, the use of C3 for luminescence, and the fact that this is very versatile. It does look great on a leather strap. It does look actually pretty dang cool on polished Milanese mesh. And I think overall, this one would be really fun to wear and really kind of completes my trio, brings some strength, some variety, some strong design language across the board here. Now, price-wise, retail price, I'm looking at about $13,000 to acquire these three watches. Why is it so high when you're looking at Longines? Well, keep in mind, two of them are limited editions. One of them is made out of precious metal. But the nice thing with Longines is it's a fairly soft brand when it comes to getting discounts. So I could get all three of these watches likely for under $10,000, right around that $9,000 to $10,000 price point. And if I'm spending under $10,000 and considering precious metal, considering the two straps, the modified ETA movements, the award-winning chronograph here, I actually think I'm doing pretty well when it comes to the price and what I'm getting in return. So these would be my picks. I'd be interested to hear your guys' thoughts on it. What do you think about Longines as a brand? What would be your three picks as we consider this brand? And guys, if you have a request for next week's only episode, what brand you would like to see, go ahead and let me know in the comment section. So thanks for taking the time to watch today, guys. I really do appreciate it. I appreciate all the comments, all of the support, the likes, the subscriptions, and you know, it does help me out quite a bit. And I want to thank you guys for that. All right, we'll see you in the next video.